At first glance, the aesthetic and personality of Blood Bowl 3 is reminiscent of classic footbrawlers like NFL Blitz in a fantasy setting, but it's actually a strategy RPG. It is, in fact, originally based on a tabletop role-playing game set in the Warhammer universe. Players form teams using several different races, and each team has specific strengths and weaknesses that help you determine which you want to use based on your playstyle. Depending on their role, each team member has their own suite of stats and skills, but it's up to you to utilize them to the best of your ability. It all sounds pretty straightforward for a turn-based tactical title, but there is a lot more to Blood Bowl than you might think. From the opening cutscenes leading to the coin flip, I was introduced to several mechanics in which I would receive both buffs and debuffs that affected my play down the line, and it has a lot to take in if you haven't played Blood Bowl before. Sadly, there is no tutorial included to teach new players the ropes. That aside, each game begins by determining what the weather will be like with the ability to change later on. Whatever the weather is may cause certain effects while playing, like needing to substitute players more often due to the sweltering heat. In preparation for the match, players are introduced to inducements, aka items that can be used in their favor. But if you are new to Blood Bowl, it doesn't do a good job informing you on what these items do unless you have the currency to purchase one. Blood Bowl 3 works on a grid-based system with the goal being to, of course, get to the end zone. Each turn is timed, requiring you to be quick on your feet to figure out how you want to move forward. When it comes to selecting your teams, there are default creations that you can choose, as well as the option to build teams from the ground up. Unfortunately, however, you cannot choose any race to be on any custom team. It must be based on the teams already built in, so the customization really comes into play based on recruiting the right characters, and regrettably, I did not have the opportunity to learn more in the process. Additionally, there are options to hire staff that help you in games and the ability to design your jersey, cheerleaders, and coaches. For returning Blood Bowl players, developer Cyanide Studio has confirmed that Blood Bowl 3 will have 12 playable teams at launch. It will also include two new teams, the Black Orcs and the Imperial Nobility, both of which will be playable in the beta. There's also a story-based campaign sometime down the line alongside a myriad of multiplayer modes which have yet to be announced. Those who know the rules and intricacies of the original tabletop game or previous two video games will likely feel right at home in Blood Bowl 3. It's now running beautifully on Unreal Engine 4, and there seems to be a lot there when it comes to the features. Just don't come in expecting a traditional football game. This is a strategy game, and all strategy games have a certain amount of depth that affects the learning curve. Blood Bowl 3 just happens to have a steep one, so be prepared to commit a lot of time to understand everything going on under the hood. This beta is the perfect opportunity to see and find out for yourself if it is worth digging into. The beta is available now on Steam, which you can register on the Blood Bowl 3 website. Early access is currently being targeted for September, with a full release cited for February 2022 on PC. For more on sports, check out our review of MLB The Show 21, and for everything else in gaming, you already know where to be, IGN.